auditioned, but only three remain.
Amy from Broome in WA.
Dylan from the Northern Rivers of New South Wales.
And Denver from Rockhampton in Queensland.
Tonight, you will crown the winner of Australian Idol 2024. Judges, are you ready?
Yes!
Everybody, are you ready?
I'm just a girl from the small town of Broome chasing a dream, and I have never been this close.
I'm doing it for my family, for everyone that's ever supported me. I'm so ready for this.
I'm just a country girl from Rocky. I cannot believe I made it to the grand finale.
The desk. We missed you yesterday.
Thank you.
How are you feeling?
I feel fine, and I want to thank everybody who reached out towards me. You know, I do appreciate it, and you guys need to know I couldn't have missed this for the world. I couldn't have.
So happy to have you back, Marsha.
Thank you.
Hey, show us your gash.
Hey.
Oh, nasty.
I got stitches and everything.
Oh, so, yeah. Oh my goodness.
But it's so all good. It's all good. No, I'm good, and I go back to the hospital tonight.
Okay. Wow.
Yeah.
She's going back.
I'm going back.
Well, I love that you've glammed up for us. We love that
you're
here, right, everybody?
I'm looking at your butts as well.
Always.
Always.
Amy, it was a spectacular show last night with our top three singing their hearts out for Australia's votes. Amy singing Tina Arena, Denver on stage with her idol Morgan Evans, and that Nolsey Dylan duet.
Yeah.
That was next level, right?
Honestly, one of the most incredible shows ever. Like, yeah. Everyone is talking about it. And somehow we're going to top it tonight. So yeah. I'm so incredibly nervous and excited.
Yes. And Kyle, from thousands of hopefuls, we are down to an incredible top three, Denver, Amy and Dylan. Are you ready to find out who Australia has chosen as their champion?
Yeah, we've been talking about it for the last half an hour while we've been getting ready. And normally we can sort of pick it, but it's anyone's game tonight. Really, it is.
It really is. Well, Australia, voting has closed. And once the numbers have been verified, we will reveal who you have voted to be your next Australian Idol.
Tonight will be monumental as our grand finalists sing once more. Plus, the iconic Delta Goodrum is here to perform live. How good is that?
Yes. Well, tonight's winner will not only be crowned the next Australian Idol, but they will also win $100,000 and be signed to Sony Music. That is huge. They are here to launch a career, and winning Idol could not be a better start. So, Denver, final night of the competition. How's our country queen feeling tonight?
I'm feeling good. I'm keen. Happy to be here.
Amy, you've come all the way from Broome, WA. If you win Idol, how would this change your life?
It would be an absolute dream. You know, I feel like I've been working towards this my whole life, and it's super close, so it's wild. It's wild.
We are very close. Very close. Dylan, are you ready to hit the stage? Because Australia's ready for a show.
Mm-hmm. I'm ready. Are you guys ready?
Yeah.
You know it.
Supporters are watching live, cheering them on. Say hi to Team Denver watching from Rockhampton in central Queensland. Look at them all. Hey, guys.
And then there's big hello to Amy supporters all the way in Broome, Western Australia. We got the Amy supporters up there.
Oh, there they are.
Amazing. Looking great. She's definitely feeling the love.
I love that. And a huge welcome to Dylan's supporters who have gathered at his favourite footy club. Guys, awesome to see you all supporting your boy Dylan. I love that.
It is going off in all those locations.
Yeah.
All right, well, as they prepare to perform, it's great to have all this hometown support watching on. It's a perfect reminder of how far the Idols have come.
Yeah, three very different artists from three very different parts of Australia. Well, our grand finalists to perform tonight has brought her country charm to the Idol stage week after week. Since she was a young girl, she's been destined for greatness. Australia, this is Denver.
It's actually very hard to pinpoint where my musical journey began because I feel like it was just always there.
One of the first times she performed on stage when you were like five? Yeah. And she was such a tiny little thing, and she was dressed like a little doll and ran right to the front of the stage, and this voice just came out, and I will never forget that.
She's got the most unique voice, I swear.
Your lady.
I don't know how Devin does it, because she sounds good and I just... No.
The voice flip, this is not the time we say you do it because of the reflux.
That's a true story.
That's why my voice sounds like
that's
that.
That's why my voice sounds like that. My throat got burnt out.
Mum didn't know she had reflux and it went undiagnosed for like 2 months.
And that's why I have that thing.
Denver just brings something different to the table. Like, I haven't heard a voice like hers before.
I'm a big Denver fan. I've already got a few songs in my playlist.
I think Denver would make a good winner because she's completely different.
She lights up any room that she walks into.
She's so funny. She's so relatable. Everybody loves her, and I think she is an idol.
You know, I think she's exactly what Australia needs, and, I'm backing her all the way.
I am so incredibly proud. There's just no words I can say to describe it because when I look at her performing, everyone's like, wow, she's a superstar. Deep down, I'm like, that's my sister. Like, that girlie is my sister. I absolutely think Denver can win Australian Idol.
I took my love and I took it down. I climbed a mountain and I turned around. And I saw my reflection in the snow-covered hills where the landslide brought me down. Well, I've been afraid of change. Older, children get older, and I'm getting take it down. And if you climb a mountain and you turn around, and if you see my reflection in the snow-covered hills, well, the landslide will bring you down.
Denver.
Hello.
How are you?
I'm great. How are you?
Well, the voting's like, so, like, is it less stress tonight because, you know, voting's done and it doesn't matter?
Oh, absolutely less stress. I'm just happy to sing.
Yeah, it's great. Every time we see you, I feel like a broken record up here. You always pick the perfect song. You nail it. That's why you're in the top three. All we can say is best of luck for tonight.
Yeah. Thank you.
So Denver, that's the trick, is it? Reflux.
Yep. Get onto it, guys.
Is it reflux? Hey, listen, you know, Amy and I, we watch you in wonderment, you know, and you sing and we kind of look at each other like besties, you know. Oh, she's so good. Denver, I wish you all the luck.
Thank you.
You're a wonderful girl.
I appreciate you.
I mean, you must be sick of us by now, but like,
never.
You just make me smile. Like, I just feel like a goof every time I look at you because I'm so in awe of you. I don't think you're just an idol. I think you're an icon, and I think you're going to be such a big deal in this country, win or lose.
Thank you so much, holy.
Denver, that was so beautiful, and you look so beautiful. Doesn't she look beautiful? Denver, what is it about that song that you love so much?
When my sister was teaching me how to drive, we used to just bust it out, like so loud. I actually blew my car speakers out to this song. So worth it. But it just, it reminds me of just that time with my beautiful Mackenzie. Yeah.
Hi, girl. Hi. Well, Denver, we are live around Australia and you're on the Idol Grand Finale stage. What would a young Denver think about this moment?
I don't know. I never knew what that kid was thinking, Mum, but I think she'd be happy. Who knows?
I think she'd be very proud of
you. Yeah, we'll go with that.
Yeah. Well, we are live to Rockhampton. Everybody watching from central Queensland seems to love that performance. Look at that. Look at them go. Denver, this could be the night that you win Australian Idol. We're going to find that out very, very soon. So give it up, everybody, one more time for Denver.
Oh, what a way to open the show. The atmosphere is electric. Our top 12 are in the lounge joining the party, celebrating our grand finale. Good to have you guys back with us right now. Well, the question is, who will win Australian Idol? Right now, our top three are nervously waiting to see whose dream will come true. But for most Aussie, their dream is to own a home, their dream home.
Just about to arrive at Lara and Peter's. They have no idea what's coming.
This is our home.
Six people, three bedrooms.
Pigsty, toy room.
Hi. Two teenage girls, one room.
My fantastic cabinet work.
It needs...
Needs God.
It needs help.
We were trying really hard to have kids for a long time and we got them and we had them very quickly. And now we're... now we have no room.
Jacinta, Jordan,
Liam and Reese.
Hannah, Johnny.
Hello. How are you? Could you tell them that Dr. Chris Brown's at the door?
Jordan and Jacinta, you guys are getting your dream home.
The greatest transformations Australia has ever seen.
You guys are getting your dream home.
Congratulations.
When they take off their blindfolds, what they see is beyond their wildest dreams.
You're standing in front of your dream home right now. Are you ready?
Ready.
Okay, one final deep breath. Go for it.
What? Oh my God. This is not our home. This is not our home. This is our home. A million dreams for the world.
They're about to discover no dream is too big. Dream home. For the world.
Is not made up. From the moment they meet, whatever happens, happens.
It's an intimidating feeling, meeting a beautiful woman. Got me lost for words.
No, there you go, making it all make sense.
From the moment they walk down that road, their hope is to walk down the aisle.
Take the weight off my shoulder and make it safe to get older.
It is the dream. I'll be riding off into the sunset with some for sure.
They want to kiss you.
It'd be very nice to have someone that makes me want to come home.
I do feel very strongly about you and just thought you should know.
My name is Lash.
My feelings probably are a bit stronger than I've been letting on.
Have either of you put in any effort?
You can't say that you're the only one that puts in effort.
I'm not saying I'm the only one that puts in effort.
Kelly and I did share a kiss.
And refer to just, like, never talk to you again.
This is something that has never, ever happened before on Farmer Wants a Wife.
I did not think pineapples could ever be that sexy.
From the tropical sunshine of Queensland to the rugged beauty of the Snowy.
I can see a future out here with you.
From their first meeting...
The moment I first saw you, it took my breath away.
Oh, I'm butterflies.
..to their final heart-pounding decision.
I really want to start a life with you back on the land.
From farm to forever. Real love is... Farmer Wants a Wife.
This Easter, we've changed how these two hollow hunting egg packs look. From this to this, helping save 131,000 kilos of plastic in AU and NZ. So hunt for new look packs in store today.
It's the brand new production audiences are raving about.
Why, it's Grease Lightning!
Grease Lightning!
I'll have you.
Grease is now playing at Sydney's Capitol Theatre for a strictly limited season. Starring Jay LaGaia, Paddy Newton and Marsha Hines. Head back to Rydell High with all the hits you know and love. Tickets are selling fast, Sydney. Book now at greasemusical.com.au.
Want 100% Australian-owned energy? Well, the power to switch is in your hands. Red Energy, 100% Australian electricity and gas.
Keep your serfs off their turf!
We love you, Dragon Warrior!
I will become the world's greatest villain by destroying the world's greatest hero.
The Chameleon is nothing like anyone you've ever faced. We have to get an army of the best crooks and criminals.
Now you kids be careful of those fireworks.
Kung Fu Panda 4.
Oh!
This has never happened before. Both grand finalists going this long, winless. Lions and Magpies in the grand final rematch to save their seasons. And that's just the start of Seven's Easter Footy Fest, a blockbuster long weekend starting with the grand final rematch. Live and free on Seven Mate.
This is the grand finale, and the question on everybody's lips is, who will be the next Australian Idol? Will it be Denver? Will it be Dylan? Or will it be the next finalist to perform? From Broome in WA to our grand finale stage, she was born to be here. This is Amy!
If you told little baby Amy that she was gonna be on the Idol stage in the grand finale, I think she would have just passed out. Just.
Amy was always a lovely child, well behaved. She was always singing and putting on makeup, and she always looked like a proper diva.
I used to steal all of Mum and Auntie's lipstick.
She's like she's a little canary, never stops singing. So I thought, oh, this kid is like, one day she'll be a singer. As a mother, I was trying to tell her, oh, could you please do something else?
Nursing.
Typical Filipina mother. Amy's dad, before he passed, he was there in every performance of Amy. I knew in my heart that he wanted to see Amy doing well in that music industry. I'm so glad that I continued that dream for him.
Oh, Mom, that's really nice.
Yeah, otherwise, if I go against it...
He'd be mad.
He'll be mad at me. he'll be haunting me. So I think for Amy to come this far, I realize now that I'm so grateful that she didn't listen to me. This is it. This is her path.
Oh, poor child.
So proud, my baby.
Amy's voice, it's just like she can belt, like she can do it all, you know. She can hit you in the heart, she can blow tin off roofs, like she's a full package.
When you go through things in life like she has, and to see her getting her flowers now, it's just amazing. And I'm just so proud of her.
I love you, Amy.
We're rooting for Amy.
We're rooting for Amy.
She's so nice. Oh, she's so good. She just deserves it.
Go, Amy.
Yeah.
Sitting here And we've been talking about how amazing you have become as a performer. And I'm all teared up because, as you know, I knew your dad, you know, and in heaven, I'm sure he's up there smiling on you, honey. I am so proud of you. You've just stepped up, stepped up, stepped up, and leaving people in your wake. I am so impressed with you. I am just so impressed.
What's his name? Danny Zuko in Greece at the end when she walks out and it's just like, what? What? You're like, you've done so many like of these like, you know, classic elegant things. I absolutely love that. That was incredible. You look amazing. What?
Hi.
Look at you. What a stud.
Thank you.
Oh my God. That was incredible. I mean, I love you. I love everything you do, but that was so fun. That was really fun.
You know, not many people can pull Ariana Grande off, really, hardly anyone, and you've done it a few times. Like, the weird thing about you is a lot of musos say, when they're at a record label, they say, oh, what sort of genre? And they go, oh, I can do any genre. That's usually the worst thing for a label to hear. We want someone to know exactly who they are, what they want to be, what they can do. But you are living proof that you can actually do any genre, any vocal, any song. You've never missed a beat.
No.
And you are my favourite, and I hope you win.
Oh.
God, thank you so much. Amy! Move over every other pop star in Australia, because Amy has arrived.
Woo!
My goodness. Bang, bang into the room. Amy, that was a killer. Such a powerful song to sing on stage. Was that did that feel as good as it looked and sounded?
I had so much fun. Yeah. I absolutely love that song. It's all about women and being empowered as a woman, and yeah, it was really fun for me.
Wow.
Wow.
I think I've said this to you before, but you really just showed that stage who was boss. Amy, just a few months ago, you were living in the Kimberley, thousands of kilometres away, and tonight you could win Australian Idol. Has that sunk in for you?
I'm honestly still processing that I'm even here, so not yet, but it would be amazing to be the first Idol from WA, that's for sure.
Wouldn't it?
I'd be so honoured.
Wouldn't it? Well, if you do win, you would be the very first winner from WA. On the big screen, we are beaming live to Broome in the Kimberley, where Amy has an enormous crowd watching on. Hey, guys! Look at them, they're going off.
Bloody love ya.
Amy, you could very well be the next Australian Idol. So, give this absolute superstar some love. One more time for Amy!
Nailed it.
After the break, our young dad, Dylan from the Northern Rivers, performs live. He is singing Elton John's Tiny Dancer. You cannot miss it. But before that, it's been the best ever season of Australian Idol. From the original auditions through to our epic live shows, there's been tears and triumphs. Let's take a look back at some of the highlights.
It's been 14 years since I was last on the Australian Idol judging panel.
It's good to be back. I'm just going to watch you take your seat.
And the feather's back.
Oh, my God, yes.
Love the feather.
Ooh. I'm stoked that they asked me back.
This year was the biggest turnout we've ever had for auditions.
I'm buzzing.
Anyone can show up.
Where do you sing and perform?
For the most part, it's my shower. Many people watching.
Anyone can audition.
Do sexy for my cat. Do sexy for my cat. For pussy. For pussy cat.
Oh my goodness.
That's what it's all about, Idol.
Hey! It's just fun all around.
What's going on here?
But I've seen things that you can't unsee this season.
Yes! Don't break the table.
You don't twerk.
I've tried. Check this out. What I love about Carlos, I think what you see is what you get. So don't ask, because you'll be told.
Was that any good?
No.
Better be
home. But also, Kyle has got that incredible, kind, emotional side.
Oh, you having a normal moment? Having a...
What? How did I turn from the arsehole into the guy who burst into tears?
Kyle Sandilands, what a softie. What a softie. But he still shows the old Kyle every now and then.
Uh-oh.
Shut your pie hole.
If you come here and you carry on like a pork chop, I will bite back. I'm the dog that bites.
I'm never shocked with anything Kyle does, and we do tend to get at each other.
Oh, I didn't like it.
Kyle!
You're far better than that. Not the best.
As I sit here rolling my eyes.
So it's like having a work wife and a work grandma. Oh, that's gonna bite me. Sorry, Marsha. You are 70, though. We'll see.
Shut up.
But when you can tell someone to shut up without them being offended, there's a friendship there, there's a trust. You know what? You got to live your dreams, my friend. Just do it.
The chemistry between the three of us is really quite natural.
Thank you, guys. Thank you. This could be you one day.
Here we go. There is a lot to celebrate. I can't believe how well we did as judges.
I want to give you my fast pass.
The talent that we found this year has been outstanding.
That is what a superstar actually looks like.
Wow, this season of Australian Idol, it's just been absolutely massive. Whoa!
To the live grand finale. Very soon we will find out who you voted as the winner and who will join Idol Legends alongside the likes of Guy Sebastian and Jess Malvoy. And speaking of legends, Marsha, this year you celebrate 50 years in Australian music. My goodness. You are still on tour with Greece. A big shout out to some of the cast who are in the audience tonight. Hey, guys. And Marsha, you are about to hit the road with 40 shows lined up.
I am.
What is it that you love so much about touring?
I like the people I tour with. I like the company.
That helps.
Yeah, and I, at the end of the day, all this is great. But if I get to sing, if I'm a good girl, I get to sing. So I just want to, you know the deal, right?
It's the best. It's the cherry on
top.
Yeah,
you know, right.
It's the best part of the job.
Yeah.
Well, you can get your tickets to see Marsha at marshahines.com. I'll certainly be getting mine. Well, yes, give it up for Marsha, everybody. Every time our next idol performs, he has blown us away. He is the total package, and everyone who meets him falls in love. Australia, this is Dylan.
When I started performing when I was 12, there's no way that I thought that I'd be here in the top three of Australian Idol. Georgia's support and the family support's been amazing. Like, if I didn't have them to ground me and just have my back, I'd be so lost. We met on the first day of high school.
Yeah, and it's so lame but kind of cute. I just kind of turned around. We were like 13?
Time stood still.
No. I no joke, can actually say I understand what that means. All I could see was baby Dill clear as day. Everything else was a blur.
Oh,
it was
what a romantic.
So odd because we were so young, but I was just like, whoa. We wrote this song called Gorgeous Georgia and we were like in year 8. And I was so nervous because someone was like, Dill's gonna sing this song at assembly. Like had my name in and everything. And I was like, oh my God. It was so sweet.
Then I got friend zoned.
Sorry.
And then I got out of it.
Look. Look at these. That's the one Ruby took.
Dylan as a dad, my Lord. It has been the most amazing thing in the world. Watching him, wow, don't cry. Watching him, I think, become the man that he was actually never taught to be. And just seeing him effortlessly fall into this role as a dad. And I didn't doubt that for a second. There's no words, he's incredible. The girls adore him.
I think the one word I'd use to describe Dylan is just, he's just so sweet. Like, everyone loves him. He's actually such a father figure to all of us. Like, if you're upset, you're down, you need something, Dylan's always going to be there.
Dylan's just like the dad to everyone in the competition. When I first met him, I was like, this dude's so cool. Beautiful voice, and yeah, he's the dad to the whole group.
Yeah, I think meeting Dylan and spending the time with Dylan, getting to know Dylan has... yeah, it's really impacted me, you know. He's a dad, and I can't wait to be a dad a bit sooner now, meeting Dill. He's an amazing man, and I wouldn't be surprised if he wins this damn thing.
I want to win Australian Idol because I've been doing this for a while now, playing at places where people don't listen, and it's taken so many years to push myself to get here, and I'm just giving it all I can.
To perform at that level after watching and hearing your wife and everything you've been through, you are Australian Idol. Honestly, you are just like, seriously. And man, I've been there, I've played at those empty rooms where everyone's too busy watching like race 8 at Randwick behind you, and they don't care what you're saying, and you're waking up every day and you're watching the years go by, and you hit 30 and you're like, oh my God, well, when is it my turn? And it is so your turn, Dylan. I'm so happy for you.
Thank you.
Dylan, those gigs with nobody paying attention, honey, they're over. Okay, people will pay attention to you. You know, I really like watching you because there's nothing nicer than watching a man with his family. You're a man's man, and you're a beautiful singer. I wish you all the luck. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Yeah.
You don't need to hear from me how wonderful you are. The whole country's in love with you. You're fantastic. And to see your wife talking about how you are with your kids, that's beautiful.
Yeah.
But Guy, Sebastian and I last night were complaining that was a three-month-year-old doing it up at 8:30 at night. That kid should be in bed at 7:30. No ifs, buts, or maybe.
One and
in
a half. Bed. She was up till midnight.
One. For the Rachel. She's going to have to go on tour soon anyway.
You're right. So. You're right. They might as well just get used to it now. Brilliant work. Good luck tonight, my friend. You're a real true gentleman.
Thank you.
Dylan. Hello, gorgeous. You know what I love the most about watching you perform, Dylan, is your smile just absolutely lights up the stage and lights up the room, don't you think? Oh. Dylan, that was stunning. How much do you love that song?
Oh, I love it. George and I went to Joshua Tree and there was no TV in the room, but just and that record of Elton John's, and we listened to it constantly.
Wow, so you've listened to it a lot of times. I could tell you love that song. Now, Dylan, just a few months ago, you were a dad living in the Northern Rivers of New South Wales, painting houses for a living, and now you are an Idol Grand Finalist. Can you believe it?
It's crazy. I am pinching myself every day while I'm here, and tomorrow is going to be wild, whatever happens.
Well, you absolutely deserve to be here. You have so many new fans out of Idol, and so many of them are cheering you on. Look at them there on the screen. Guys. Everybody, let's hear it one more time for Dylan.
Thank you.
This could be the night that Dylan becomes the next Australian Idol. What an absolute superstar. Okay, well, up next, the moment you've all been waiting for. We reveal how you voted and find out which two finalists will go head to head for the Australian Idol title.
Yes, our first elimination is right after the break. Don't go anywhere. Welcome back to the live grand finale. It's now time for our first elimination of the evening, where we reveal your votes and your top three become top two.
To do that, let's bring them out.
Vocalist from Broome in Western Australia.
And Dylan, our young dad from the Northern Rivers of New South Wales.
Okay, Denver, how are the nerves holding up?
I'm equally as, like, I'm crapping my dacks, but then I'm also really chill. So I don't know how that works, but there you go.
Amy, how are you feeling?
I'm buzzing. Yeah, whatever happens, happens, I guess.
And Dylan, are you ready to find out how Australia voted?
No. No, I am. I am. Let's do it.
Should we just take another break?
No, please.
Okay.
Okay, to make it this far for you guys is an incredible achievement. Our grand finalists have worked insanely hard to be standing right here, but Australia has voted, and it is now time to reveal who is still in the running and who, unfortunately, is out of the competition. All right. Let's do this. Cue the lights.
I am holding the official results of the nationwide vote. Australia, your votes have been counted and verified. And in no particular order. The first person to make it to the top two is
Australian Idol. Well done, Amy.
Wow. The crowd in here tonight is going wild. Whew. Okay, guys. So, it comes down to Denver and Dylan. You ready?
Australia has voted, and the second person through joining Amy in the top two is...
Denver, you were so close. How are you feeling?
I'm nothing but happy. Like, my beautiful, beautiful humans. I love them both with my whole heart. Guys, I'm so blessed to have done what I've done, and yeah, I'm happy.
Yeah, give it up. She's amazing. You're incredible. Judges, any words for Denver?
Well, you know, I just know that you hold a large piece of Australia's heart, okay? And you've done a great job every night that we've seen you, Dylan. I'm in love with you. Denver, I'm in love with you, darling. You know, so regardless of what happens, you're going to be just fine.
I wouldn't pack your bags because, like, I would just keep everything in one bag, because I think you're going to go on tour like the second you leave here. Every country festival is about you. Everyone I speak to is asking about you. I want to work with you. I'm just like so, such a fan. So,
Thank you so much.
Go get busy.
Yeah, I will.
Now, I don't think this is the end of you. Like, we'll see you. We'll play you. We'll can't wait for the record. Go off and kill it. Well done.
Yeah,
we'll
do.
Well done, bye. You are an absolute star. Thank you so much for sharing your gift with us. I'm a new country fan because of your music.
Same, boo.
So for one last time, everybody, give it up for Denver!
And Dylan. They will perform one more time and then we will announce which of them will take the title of Australian Idol 2024. But next, she is one of the biggest names in Australian music. Delta Goodrum is an award-winning, chart-topping, record-breaking, hit-making megastar, and she is performing live right here.
So excited for that. The Idol Grand Finale is back in a moment. You're on our live grand finale, and in a moment's time, we're going to crown your winner for 2024. But right now, she's won 12 ARIA Awards, had countless number one records, and is an absolute force. Here to perform her new single, Hearts on the Run, which is making huge waves here and overseas, this is Delta Goodrum!
Wow, thank you so much. So great to be here on your grand finale. How lucky am I?
Voice, you're singing up in the heavens. It's amazing.
Thank you very much. Like I said, it's great to be here, a part of your big night. So congratulations to the amazing artists. Well, beautiful, beautiful judges and yourself, yes. So it's great to be here.
So good to have you with us, Delta. You are such a busy woman. You've started up your own record label. You've been touring the world. You starred in Netflix movie. You are making absolute bangers like that one, Hearts on the Run. You really can do it all. Is there something you can't do?
There's many things. We just try not to focus on
okay,
that.
Okay, we won't do that.
but no, I love getting to do what I love to do and being a part of people's lives through music. And it's another chapter in the book. And I'm excited for this chapter at the moment. I'm enjoying every minute of it. Just doing what we love, doing it with good people and enjoying it.
Absolutely. Yes. Now, Kyle, you first met Delta at a very young age, and look at her now.
Man, knowing that at 15 or 14, Delta was sitting in her pyjamas, cross-legged in her single bed, ringing up the Hot 30 countdown, voting for your own song.
I was.
And then meeting you, and then we'd come out to your house and you did a performance for us, and I was like, wow, this chick's going to be big. And then, I just said to Masha, holy shit, that's Delta Goodrum with the fireworks. And the,
yeah.
Mate,
yeah.
Congratulations. I feel like a big brother. I'm so proud. I think we all knew from the start you were going to be something amazing, but you just keep giving it, and we just couldn't be prouder of you.
Thank you so much.
Do you remember those days? Do you remember meeting Kyle all those years ago?
Of course I do. I mean, we grew up in the industry together. Yeah. I'll never forget being a 15-year-old, and Kyle and the whole team were already on fire. They were already taking over the airwaves, so they've dominated ever since,
yeah.
and there's a reason for that, and I love to be able to be entertained by Kyle my whole life as well.
Well, we entertain each other.
Yes. Same with you, though, much like yourself. We love you. We love that we get to have you. We love having you on this show. Delta, you are such an inspiration to all of us. The new single, Hearts on the Run, is available to download and stream right now. Give it up for the one and only Delta Goodrum. That was amazing.
Thank you. Bye, everybody. Have a great night. Bye.
Well, things are truly heating up now. Our two finalists, Amy and Dylan, are about to go head-to-head, performing the songs they originally auditioned with. A full circle moment for both of them. Then we announce your winner of Australian Idol 2024. Who will it be? You're locked on Idol. Find out soon. This is the live grand finale. The tension is building as we get closer to finding out whether Amy or Dylan will be crowned your winner of Australian Idol. I'm here with Amy's support crew led by her mum, Judy. Isn't this just wild? Like, you knew Amy had talent, but top two in Australian Idol?
Oh my God. I knew that she's always a talented singer, but it's just everything is beyond my expectation. It's like so surreal. It's like I can't believe it.
Absolutely. Well, it has been a huge journey for Amy, our powerhouse vocalist from Broome in WA. Let's take a look back at where it all started.
You're going to be so hard to beat.
When I first sung Natural Woman, it's the moment that changed everything for me.
Did you make me feel like a natural woman? Natural.
That.
I think the word you're looking for is amazing.
Oh, thank you. Oh, you guys are gonna make me cry. Right after my audition song, you know, Marsha gave me this big hug.
Do it for your dad.
Thank you. And she said, do it for your dad. And I know he's smiling up there. He's rocking out and just the proudest. Yeah, I have no doubt in my mind about that.
This golden ticket's for you. Welcome to the top 30.
I will be shocked to the core if you are not in the top five.
Top 21 week was absolute horror.
Oh my God.
I was so sick right up until the day before of the performance, but it was like, nah, Amy, you need to put your big girl pants on and you just need to push through it.
Freedom, 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 freedom.
It was gorgeous to watch.
Everywhere I go, everyone is amazed by you.
A couple of weeks ago, no one knew who I was.
First up is Amy.
The biggest surprise was the support from Australia. It's really crazy.
This experience has opened so many doors for me.
Hi! Oh my goodness!
Meeting my idol Jess was a moment that I'll remember for the rest of my life.
Surprise!
I see that that passion that you have really reminds me of me when I started out.
Don't say that! Oh my God!
Singing my idol song for my idol, it was, first of all, very daunting. I hope she's proud of it because I know I sure am.
Australia, that is what a superstar actually looks like.
I feel like I've grown up somehow in this competition.
Yes! Now that's what we're talking about up here.
I feel like I've struggled with imposter syndrome like my whole life. And it's like, whoa, like Amy, just wake up, because like, look at what you've done and look at what you can do. Like, that is the biggest thing for me. I'm just, it's been amazing.
Say something.
Yeah. Oh yeah, that was exactly like the first audition. Yeah. You know how good, remember how good she was at the first audition just with no one? And then you add that band, you add that stage, you add those backing vocalists. That there is a true superstar, ladies and gentlemen. Beautiful job. Beautiful person. Good luck.
You look and sound like $1 million. You always have. And I just think, I keep saying it, like Hal said, broken record. I couldn't be more proud of you, Amy, because you've done so well and you've just been such a nice person. Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you, guys.
The best thing about you is, like, you've got this massive, huge diva voice that's just unmatched, but then you're not a diva. You are a beautiful, beautiful soul.
Give it time.
And everyone... No, but honestly, everyone's going to work with you. Everyone's going to want to be around you and go to your shows. And you're just, you're one of those people that you just, it feels so good to be around you.
Exactly.
So.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Wow. Now, can I just say, and I hope you don't mind me saying this, but this morning, Amy could not speak. So that final note at the end had me floored. Unbelievable. Wow. Amy, when you auditioned, did you ever imagine that you would be here on this stage right now?
Absolutely not. It honestly still feels like a little bit of a dream. That's why I keep looking around. I'm like, is this happening? Yeah, I can't believe it. And
we'll believe
I'm so, so grateful.
Believe it, because you are a... Amazing. Amy, we are now moments away from finding out if you have been voted as the next Australian Idol. Best of luck. You are incredible. Give it up one more time for Amy. I can't say wow enough times.
Next on Idol, we recap Dylan's mighty campaign from audition to grand finale before he wraps it up with one last performance. The Idol live finale is back in a moment.
Welcome back to Idol. We are inching closer to revealing who you voted into the top spot. Before the break, we heard from Amy for the last time, and now it's Dylan's turn. I'm here with his wife, Georgia. Georgia, what do you want to say to Dylan for the very last time before he runs out onto stage?
Oh, wowza. We're here, and that's insane. To be honest, no matter what happens, I'm just so excited for what's next. I know no matter what happens, this isn't the end, and Amy's incredible. So I'm just actually really excited for what's next, because I know no matter what happens, yeah, it's just, I don't know, yeah, it's crazy.
You're excited. Australia's excited. Let's take a quick look back at when we first met the young dad from the Northern Rivers of New South Wales. This is Dylan.
Are you just like a short neck?
Boom, boom, winner, winner, chicken dinner.
It's so surreal. I dreamt of this moment, but I didn't really think that I could get here.
So nice to meet you.
Dylan, nice to meet you.
Hello, gorgeous.
Say hello.
Do you think that your dad could be the next Australian Idol?
When I was 12, my mum pushed me onto the street to start busking.
Does she know you're here today?
She passed away almost 10 years ago now.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
It's YTLU. Better be home soon.
Sorry. I don't usually cry in the presence of other men.
That's probably one of the most heartfelt performances I've seen.
This golden ticket's for you. Welcome to the top 30.
It was super special to dedicate that song to Mum, because if it wasn't for her, there's no way that I would be here. From the first audition to now, I feel like I've grown so much.
Have you ever seen the rain?
Amy had goosebumps.
That is exactly what we're looking for at this level. You are the perfect recording artist.
Yeah, so grateful for all the experiences that I've had on Australian Idol. It's been amazing.
Yay!
I didn't expect all the contestants to get along and kind of form this little family.
All right, cut the cake. Come on, Dil.
OK, well, here we go.
Yay! Yay!
I think Mum would be so proud if she was here. She probably is here.
When I wake up.
Mum's always been by my side the whole journey, and I know it's kind of nice to just have that feeling of her with me. Yeah, I think she would just be smiling ear to ear. Yeah. Yeah.
Mum just makes you think, we're so lucky to be here. You've got to live your dreams, my friend. Do it for your family.
Having Georgia and the girls there has been so incredible. Just reiterates why I'm here, because I'm doing it for her, I'm doing it for the girls, and I'm doing it for my family. Knowing that I'm so close, I want it so bad. Just, I want to be on that stage and take in every moment and just be announced as the winner.
Something's got a hold on you, and it's pushing me aside. See it stretch on forever, and I know I'm right for the first time in my life.
That's why I tell you, you better be home soon. Don't say no, don't say nothing's wrong. 'Cause when you get back home, maybe I'll be gone. Oh, when the lights go out, it will cause me pain. We were to end it, but I can't start again. You can depend on me. Hey! Yeah, I know I.
That was one of the first songs in our audition. And as you remember, you made Kyle cry. And just a few moments ago, when you started, he went, uh-oh.
I did.
So look, you've been so consistent through it all and such a nice person through it all. And all I can say to you is thank you for being an Australian Idol. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thanks for having me.
You're welcome.
I know that you obviously love that song, but I recall you saying that you went and saw Crowded House with your mum before she passed, and I just don't know how you do this, but it's just so remarkable watching you play. And I'm not a real like woo-woo sort of person, but I do believe she's here, and I do believe that good things happen to good people, and it's that simple. And you're a really good person, and you're so talented.
Thank you. I'm trying not to cry. I'll leave that till after.
Yeah, I think where I get triggered by you and all your beautiful vocals is the better be home soon. I was a bit of a mummy's boy as well, and you know what it's like. And to see you and your kids and me and my kid, it like every time, I don't know what it is. Probably would have been easy for us to get rid of you early in the piece so I didn't look like such a pussy. But man, you are truly remarkable and a decent human being. This isn't all just fuzz and rubbish. You're a decent human being. And you deserve it. Good luck, man. Good luck.
Thank you.
Not long now. Oh, God, now. It's happening now.
It's happening. It's not happening just yet. You are Kyle's kryptonite. We've figured it out.
Yeah,
who'd have thunk?
That's
my
true.
My gosh.
For sure.
Dylan, when you signed up for Idol, did you expect to go this far and be on the edge of Idol glory?
No way. No, this is just a big, big dream. I hoped for top 12, and like I watched it as a kid. I was playing handball with my friends in year three and arguing about if Guy or Shannon was going to win. Like, I've watched Idol forever, and to be on this stage and doing this is just incredible.
And singing with Knowlesy last night.
And singing with Knowlesy. Yeah.
My gosh. Well, Dylan, you have done everything you could possibly do to walk away with the Idol title. Let's hear it for Dylan! Oh, Scotty. All right, this is it, people.
We are painstakingly close to revealing the results and learning who you chose as your champion. Will it be Amy? Or will it be Dylan?
You voted, you decided, and straight after the break, we will crown the winner of Australian Idol 2024. Don't move a muscle. We're back in moments.
You decide the winner of Australian Idol 2024. They'll earn the winning title, joining the ranks of Idol legends before them. Score a recording contract with Sony Music Entertainment Australia and win an epic $100,000 to supercharge their music career.
It is a life-changing prize for the winner, who will also receive $100,000 and will be signed to Sony Music Australia.
And if you want to be standing on the Australian Idol stage next year, auditions are now open.
That's right. If you think you have what it takes to be the next Australian Idol, apply now at idolauditions.com.au. Is everybody ready? We can't wait any longer. There's just two ways this can go now. So, for the last time, please welcome back your grand finalists.
From Broome in Western Australia, it's our powerhouse vocalist, Amy.
And from the Northern Rivers of New South Wales, it's our young dad, Dylan. All right, well, it has been an enormous season that many have described as the best season of Idol ever. We have had a number one single, broken voting records, and captured the hearts of the entire country. Even our Prime Minister Albo is a huge fan. But after thousands of auditions, so many incredible weeks of competition, and millions of your votes, it all comes down to this very moment.
Has Australia chosen Amy to be the next Australian Idol? Or is Dylan set to write his name in the Idol history books? Judges.
Kyle, two incredibly talented, hardworking artists up here on this stage. Both have come so far on their Idol journey, but this is just the beginning, right?
Absolutely. As judges, what we want is to deliver up the best that we've found.
Absolutely.
Both of these two I'd be pleased to manage, to sign. They both have amazing records. They're both just fantastic, right?
Yeah, you guys.
Couldn't be happier.
Regardless, I just have to congratulate you. Regardless.
Marsha, no matter how it goes this way, we can expect big things from either of them, right?
Look, you'll work hard because you've got a great work ethic, guys. I've seen it up on this stage each time you present yourself. So, you know, have fun with it. It's a crazy business, but enjoy the ride. Okay? Yeah.
After an epic season of Idol, it's all coming to a close. Are you ready to find out who wins Australian Idol 2024 or what?
Let's just do it, okay? And all don't right. mess around with ad breaks or anything
okay,
like that.
Okay, okay. Amy, any last words before we make the big announcement?
Just thank you so much for getting me here. No matter the outcome, I'm really honoured to be here. Thank you so much.
And Dylan, how about you?
I'm so honoured and humbled by this whole experience and the support of everyone and the community from back home. It's just, and my family, it's just amazing.
Okay. It's time to reveal the results of Australia's vote.
Good luck to both of you.
For the very last time this season, hit the lights.
Australia, you voted, you decided. The votes have been counted and verified.
From thousands who auditioned, there can only be one who takes the title. The winner of Australian Idol 2024 is...
Thank you. I don't know. I'm about to cry, so thanks.
Well, let me say something for you. Dylan, you are the Australian Idol!
Okay, here we go. And now performing his winning single, Paper Heart, this is Dylan! Thank you to everyone involved, and for a final time this year, thank you to our sensational judges.
Carl Sanderlands.
Marsha Hines.
And Amy Shaw.
See you next year.
Good night, Australia.
We're gonna build a life together. You and I forever and ever, and we'll make babies on the beach under the stardust.
Wow.
And I'll hear your voice. come to the door 1,000 times, maybe more, and I'll smile inside to know you're mine completely.
The last thing we need here is one of us falling in love.
We're gonna build our lives together, you and I, forever and ever and ever. We'll make lots and lots of babies on the beach, and I will hear your voice come through the door 1,000 times, maybe more. A smile inside to know you.